This is Jim Emter, Van Onn & Company, Alexandria, Minnesota, with their closing grain and livestock comments for September 21st, 2018. Corn market up 4 3/4 today. Beans down 3. Chicago wheat down 2 1/4. Minneapolis wheat down 6. Kansas City down 1 3/4. On the true weekly, we're up 20 1/4 on the corn, 25 3/4 on the beans, 41 3/4 on the Chicago wheat, up 25 1/2 on the Minneapolis wheat, Kansas City up 46 1/4. When you look at the actual movement for the December contract in corn, it was up 5 1/2 on the week. The beans were up 16 3/4 and the Chicago wheat up 10 1/4. So obviously some big weekly reversals off the expiration of the September contracts for the grains and a good buildup for the week. So nonetheless, we saw higher weekly posted. And we kind of show reversals for corn, soybeans, and wheat. Now, how do we build off those? We'll be dictative off demand as we work ahead. And we still got harvest in front of us here yet. So again, I don't think they'll get away from us too quickly, but encouraging you to see that momentum in post-harvest. I think it gives us some optimism of building, at least for the corn and wheat markets. The beans are still a wild card based off the China-U.S. relationship. Live cattle up 55 on the day Friday. Feeders up 127 1/2. Lean hogs down 95. On the weeklies, live cattle down 75, feeder cattle down 47 1/2, lean hogs up 407 1/2. Dollar index for the week, equally important, down over a buck. We had cash cattle trade 112 live, 175 dress. We'll see if that pulls back a little bit. The cattle on feed report was a bit negative with 107% placements versus 104 expected and a 1% higher on the on feed number. So next week, maybe a little negative start to the cattle, but we've had some good exports and supportive markets. So we'll see if cash can't carry us. On the hog side of things, African swine fevers continues to be a focal point. And again, even though we're up against the 200-day moving average and against stiff resistance, we'll see if we can't build off some strength into next week. This has been Jim Emter, Van Onn & Company, Alexandria, Minnesota. Trading in futures and options involves risk of loss and is not suitable for all producers. Past performance is not indicative of future results. This is a solicitation. Have a great afternoon.